Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we gonna learn about the pancrease. Okay, this is pancrease. This is the protection of the pancreas in our body. And this is the pancreas, and this is the duodenum. Okay. First of all, this is the head of pancreas. This part is the neck of pancreas. This is its body, and this is the tail. And below here, this is the uncinate process. Okay, for the surface of the pancreas, we have three surfaces. This is the anterior surface, above here, and this is the inferior surface. Behind here is the posterior surface. And for borders, also we have three borders. This is the superior border. This is the anterior border, and this is the inferior border. Okay, for the relation for the head of the pancreas. Okay, this pancreas, it lies in the concavity of the duodenum. First of all, it is related to the first part of duodenum superiorly, and the second part of duodenum on the right side, and this is the second part of the duodenum. It is separated between the second part of the duodenum by the superior and inferior pancreatico-duodenal artery. And inferiorly, it is related to the third part of the duodenum. For the anterior relation, it is related to the transverse colon. Is right here. This related to the transverse colon, and posteriorly, it is related to the inferior vena cava, renal vein, renal vein, and also the common bile duct. And for the uncinate process, right here, this is the uncinate process. It lies between the abdominal aorta and superior mesenteric arteries. Okay, now we're gonna speak about the neck. The relation for the neck of pancreas, right here. Anteriorly, we have it is related to gastroduodenal junction, and posteriorly, the neck is related to the formation of portal vein from splenic and superior mesenteric vein. Okay. And for the body, we have three surfaces, which is anterior, inferior, and posterior. Behind here, and the relation for anterior surface, it is related to stomach, separated by the lesser sac. And for the inferior surface, it is related to the duodenal flexure, loops of ileum, and end of transverse colon from right to left. Okay. And then for the posterior surface, we have seven relation for the posterior surface. A, 5L and AS. Okay, for the first one is the left psoas major, left crust of diaphragm, left kidney, left suprarenal gland, left sympathetic chain, and AS. A is aorta and origin of superior mesenteric artery, and S is the splenic and left renal vein. Okay, and then now we move to the relation for the borders. Okay, for the superior border, it is related to the splenic artery. And for the anterior border, it gives the attachment to the transverse mesocolon and also greater omentum. For the inferior border, it separates the inferior surface here. This is the inferior surface right here. Inferior surface. It separates the inferior surface from the posterior surface for the inferior border. And then for the tail of pancreas. It is related to the visceral surface of spleen. near the spleen hilum. It is related to the visceral surface of the spleen near its hilum, and it reach the hilum of the spleen via the lieno renal ligament. And lastly, for the blood supply of the pancreas, for the head, it is supplied by the superior and inferior pancreatic or duodenal arteries. And for the rest of the pancreas, which is the neck, the body, the tail, it is supplied by the pancreatic branches of splenic artery. And lastly, for the venous drainage, it drains to the splenic vein and also portal vein.